A group of ordinary citizens have organized a slow drive from various points around Pretoria against farm attacks. The motorcades will meet up at the union buildings where a memorandum will be handed over. Farmers and supporters from far and wide are expected to take part. A new spate of farm murders has prompted urgent calls for the government to curb the surge. The latest murder involved a pregnant woman who was killed during a home invasion on her farm in Vienen in KwaZulu-Natal. Our reporter Molemo Wawanamutwa has more. Let's cross live to her.
Well, last week thousands of bikers against farm attacks embarked on a mass ride, highlighting the plight of farmers, as well as calling for President Cyril Ramaphosa to take all possible measures to protect farmers. And as police have reported that for the financial year 2019-2020, there have been about 50 farm murders, of which these farmers are saying one is one too many. And today they are gathering in different parts of Pretoria to continue their mass ride in their vehicles, ultimately to get to the union buildings to hand over their memorandum. With me here is their spokesperson, Kaliru. Kali, if you can just tell us as to what is different with today's mass ride compared to last week's.
Yeah, thank you very much. First, I want to say thank you for everybody that is for their participation today, for partaking this action again. Last week it was the motorcycles, this today is the vehicles. So yeah, it's the same principle. This is our voice that we raise for four murders, and we ask and we want Mr. Ramaphosa to immediately take action to stop these brutal farm murders. It's not the farm murders, but also the families and the employees. And the farmers is our food security, and we need action plans, immediate action plans, to stop it immediately. This is what you can see at the back of me. People are concerned, we are concerned, South Africans, because we say enough is enough. And this must be stopped immediately. And this is why we're here today, again with the vehicles. And this will continue until the demands are met regarding farm murders and attacks on our farmers, families, and also their employees.
There have been concerns that these attackers don't just, steal. Items like your televisions and whatever, they actually go there with the intention to cause bodily harm. And what do you think really the motive is behind these farm attacks?
I think there is, and also just to clarify, this is not a political organization, and it's not a political march. This is concern South Africa's, and this is our concern, because these brutal murders that took place, there is no robbery, there is no theft. I think people and political leaders stands on platforms and say to the people, go and take the land. I think because we can see what happened with the land grabs, and I think this is a flow out on the farm murders that is linked to the land grabs, and we say no, you can't take the land, please stop harassing our farmers, stop murdering our farmers, because this is not a solution. The solution needs to be taken in Parliament with all the necessary political parties involved to negotiate, not only the government alone, but also with the agriculture sector, with the private security sector, to put in place action plans to prevent all these farm attackers.
And also concerns about the president's silence.
Yeah, I think that is the main concern, because this is what we want him to do. We want him to stand up in front of South Africa and say, people, this is not acceptable. This is not acceptable. This cannot continue. And he needs to condemn this attacks from the platform he is speaking to South Africa. And not South Africa, but also internationally.
Thank you, Kali.
Thank you very much.
Well, this is Kaliru representing this campaign for farm attacks. as they are now will be leaving to Pretoria, to the Union Buildings, to hand over their memorandum. That's back to the studio.